Now, there is something that we should be knowing, like how application gets identified. How application gets identified. Now, here is the start process. Start. Check IP and port. Okay. Which IP it is taking? Okay. Which port it is communicating to? All right. Now, it will check the policy. It will check the policy, whether it should be allowed or not. The policy is saying, I don't know what application it is using. It seems similar, but I don't know. Now, it say it seems similar. Then what it needs to further analyze it. It need to further analyze it. And what it will do for that analysis, it will check application signatures. We know that we have application signatures, correct? Yes, no? Anyone who have experience on AV antivirus? Anyone heard of the term AV antivirus? Sorry? Okay. So antivirus uses signatures.
It
So what are those signatures? Signatures are nothing but a static value.
the
Whenever any certain process, like say
signature.
Adobe,
Correct. I done.
okay, whenever any certain process like Adobe, like EXE, like Excel, when any certain application performs action on any of the data type, right? So what happens in that case? In that case, your application gets identified based upon their signatures. Now it will check the signatures. Now after checking signatures, I'm still not able to find out. I'm not still able to find out. I'll say I'm not able to find out what application it is. It is something like rocket science to me. Please explain what it is. Then it will say, don't get nervous. Let me help you out. It will perform three actions. Any of the one. Not every one, not all the three action, but any of the one. It will perform three actions. Unknown protocol decoder. Now application identified. This protocol I have not seen before. All right. So what it will do? It will perform the heuristic search. It will perform the heuristic search. After performing heuristic search, heuristic, you can Google it. It is a mechanism. It is an algorithm that is being used. Okay. Heuristic search is the algorithm that is being used to identify the relevant information. Clear? So it will check the application by applying the heuristic search. It will check the policy. If policy is saying, I still am not able to identify, it will again perform, again perform, again perform. And if at end of the day it is saying, okay, I don't know, it will drop it. Else, if it is an identified traffic, no decoding is required. If it is an identified traffic, no decoding is required. Like say Facebook, I already know it is a Facebook. Okay, why will I take headache of decoding it again and again when I know it is of Facebook? Then it is a known protocol, like say FTP. It is a known protocol, but it is a customized FTP for my organization, for my company. Right? So it is a known protocol. So if it is a known protocol, then in that case, what it will be doing? It will require decoding. While decoding, it will check the decode, then check signature, then again check policy. Same process goes on and on and on. Signature will say, this is not FTP. But after decoding, it will identify it is FTP. So your Palo Alto will get confused. In any custom application of FTP, if you are using in your environment, right? So that particular thing, it will not get identified straight away. Getting my point? So what I'm saying here, these are the three processes that Palo Alto performs in case of application identification. If it is known application, known protocol it is using, it will go through this. If it is all together unknown, it will go through this. If it is an identified traffic, it will go through like this. Then all the way it will be report and enforce the policy. Whatever policy it is saying, allow, deny, whatever action it is saying, it will perform that particular action. Clear, not clear, maybe? Anyone who is clear?
So this is anyone only clear? This is only to identify the application.
This particular slide is only talking about the application.
So we are talking about the antivirus. So what is the relation there?
See, don't get confused yourself with the antivirus. That particular packet flow, we are done. We understand how packet flow works. What we are saying here, if there is an application, if there is a new application, every day we create a new application, we have new applications created somewhere across the globe, isn't it? Like Zoom, when Zoom was first introduced, it was a new application for every appliance, isn't it? And nowadays, it is a very common application. Getting my point?
Yes.
So what I'm saying here, if application doesn't get identified, like if it is a Facebook, Google Maps, Google Calendar, or audio video, any application it is using, like Zoom it is using. So if it does not have those applications identified, then this is the process how it will get identified. Okay. For known protocols, like say FTP, but it is custom FTP, it will come under known protocol decoder. If it is altogether a new protocol, it will come under unknown protocol. If it is identified traffic, it will come like this.
So do we need any license for this one? There is any separate license?
This part does not require license. This is a default feature which is applicable in. Yes.